Alright, so in today's video, we'll be unboxing the Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom Collector's Edition, as well as some extra stuff that Best Buy gives out for pre-order, and as well as the case for the OLED, which I did a different video for, and the amiibo, and let's get into it. Alright, so less than an hour ago, picked this guy up, and just making a video, just gonna post this directly as soon as I'm done editing it, and it'll be up on the channel. As you guys are seeing it. And so we're gonna go through, I'm gonna change the camera over to the top down angle, and we're gonna go open up everything. I'm gonna open up the case, the amiibo, the collector's edition, as well as this art print, which is kind of cool, that is exclusive to Best Buy, I believe, if you pre-order it. There's other ones if you pre-ordered it through GameStop or other companies. I actually don't know what the other ones would be. Maybe Nintendo themselves. Let's go ahead and switch camera angles and unbox this guy. All right, so we're gonna leave the collector's edition till the end. So let's just scoot that over. So we got the amiibo. I actually really like this amiibo. I really like his stance and everything they chose for this guy, as well as like all the promotion that they've done around this stance. I actually think it's really amazing. I just like it. I don't know why. I like the base. Once I open it up, I'll show you guys, but these, I don't have a really good way of opening amiibo because they don't open up really well, and I usually open them up. So we'll just toss all the extra stuff to the side and get the amiibo out. This is gonna be loud for a second. Hopefully in editing, I can reduce the sound there. Throw that stuff to the side. There's your Link with the destroyed hand. I'm not actually sure. I don't remember exactly what the lore is around that. It looks like he has the Master Sword, so that must be early on in the game. I'm not 100% sure since I haven't played it yet. But I do like the base, like I said before, with the Triforce on it. Try to get a good view. There you go. There's a good shot of the base. And then nice shot of the amiibo. Now there's that guy. Set that to the side. Let's go ahead and open up the case next. And it looks like it has tape on it, so be careful to just cut it slightly. Just the tape, not trying to destroy the box or anything. Just like that. Put the knife away. Safety first. And I think that's it. And then, yep. Throw the box to the side for a second. I'm keeping it, but I'm gonna throw it to the side. I think this is the screen protector, and I believe it works on either of the switches, which is kind of cool. So I don't know why it's red. It's probably to try to tell you the difference between the layers as you peel them off to put on the switch. So leave that to the side. I might actually use that. I used the other one. Oh. Maybe one's for the OLED, one's for the regular switch. Not exactly sure. Set that to the side. Go ahead and open this guy up. I really like this one. This is a really nice case. Really nice. Trying to get as much detail for you guys as possible with the light. There's the back. I like the gold accent. That's really nice. And then the Triforce with some type of symbol around it. I'm not sure what that is. We'll probably find out playing the game. We also don't know about these circles and all of this other stuff, so we'll learn that playing the game. I'm gonna play it live today after this video actually is up, so go ahead and check our live out as we play through Breath of the Wild. Not Breath of the Wild, Tears of the Kingdom. See about opening it. I'm sure it's just, yeah, it's just like the other case that I got for the first OLED, like the original OLED. It was just white on the outside. So this is just the exact same like minimal case, which is kind of nice to have. I like having the minimal case for different reasons. Like sometimes I want to carry around just this small case that I don't have to worry about anything else. So set that to the side. Let's do the art print next. And it looks like there's actually a barcode, which is kind of really, that's really cool that they put a barcode there. Lovely plastic sound. I try to reduce the sound there. This is really nice. It's got like a layer here, and then that, I love this background. I actually use this for one of my thumbnails for my lives that we're gonna be going through, so you'll see this on a thumbnail. And I think that's it. I think that's all together. It's just a very thick art print, which is really cool. I'm gonna wind up putting it back in this plastic material because I want to protect it until maybe I can get an actual frame for it. This one I definitely want to get a frame for immediately, so set that to the side. And the reason why you clicked on the video, here's the collector's edition. This thing is very large. I can't even get it on camera fully, as otherwise it kind of is just too far away and there's no point of having the top down. So let's check out the back. I don't know too much about this since we haven't played the game yet. I believe that's either Ganon or Demise or whoever the main villain is in the game, but I don't believe it's Ganon, so at least not the Ganon that we played in the first game. And then I think that's either Zelda or the first incarnation of Zelda, and then a Tear of the Kingdom. I believe there's 7 that they found, or as part of the hieroglyphics is that they actually have like a 7 showing. So there also includes what is included in this, so we'll get that for you. That's all the stuff that's included, E10 plus. So let's go ahead and open this guy up. I might take the sticker off instead of cutting it off or cutting through it, but it looks like it's gonna chip away at it, so I'd rather just keep the sticker and just permanently attach the sticker to the case. I prefer that other than ripping the case and then winding up with a bunch of white specks around the actual decals or the design of the box. So put the knife away, make sure we're safe there. And I don't know why boxes are designed like this, or it's very hard to open. They always have these lips that are terrible to open, but got it open. And I think I opened it upside down, so we're gonna have to flip that and set the box aside. All right, so we got the top here, and that almost is perfectly in frame. So we got the steel book. So let's go ahead and open that up then. Try to keep the plastic all together. Oh, there's the steel book. Hey, look, there's my camera. And there it is. So there's 7 right there, but there's 2 over here. So is that 9, or are those 2 part of this? I guess we'll find out. All right, let's put the book back in the sleeve here. And we got the game, but I'm gonna leave the game till the end because I want to open that at the end. So let's go ahead and open this guy up. This is, I actually don't know what this is. I didn't look at what was in it, not too closely at least. I don't remember anything that's in this. So let's go ahead and open this up. Lots of plastic. Oh, it looks like pins. I don't know if these are the Divine Beasts or something else, but they're little pins. So that's really cool. I'm not gonna show all of them, but there's that. I guess I could show the back of this one since I showed the front. There's the back. And they're probably all similar, so just gonna set stuff aside rather than putting it back in, but I'm gonna put it all back in later. Might do a speed run of putting it all back together, but most likely not. And we got the art book, I believe. And I don't know if there's spoilers in this. I'm gonna open it, but I don't know if there's any spoilers in this, so just be warned. I'm not gonna try to look at it, because I don't want to be spoiled. So if you don't want to be spoiled, don't, just keep watching the video, but don't look at what's inside of this. I'm hoping it tells me if there's spoilers. I've had a few books tell me that there's spoilers inside the book and not to do it until you play the game, but. So there's the front. I really like these designs. Super nice. Don't know what that is. I don't know if that was supposed to be there. It doesn't look like it. It looks like a piece of glue, so I took that off. So let's go ahead and open it up. The images were during the developing process. They may differ from designs in the game. That's what this little text down here says. So this doesn't actually contain spoilers then, if they're potentially not even this, but some masks that you might get in the game. And yeah, so really nice art book. I'm not gonna go into it in detail. Let me know down in the comments if you do want to see like a video of me going through it in detail later on after I've beaten the game, as I don't want to spoil anything. So continue. I don't know. Steel poster is what that says. So let's go ahead and open the game up just to get done with the first box. That's actually hard to get out that way. So let's go ahead and pop this guy open. So I know sadly there is a day one patch, I've heard. So this is not, it is playable, I believe, right out of the box, but it does require an update if you want the best performance. So there's the back and the front again. And it looks like there's kind of a reversible cover, so we'll take that out. There is the cartridge in case you care about the design of the actual cartridge. And then there is the reverse cover, which I kind of like. I don't know if it's supposed to be a reversible cover or not, or just detail on the inside. So I'm not going to flip it. Not yet, at least. But since it doesn't say the game on it, I probably won't flip it now that I'm thinking about it. Just so that it, if it's on the shelf or anything like that, you would know which game it is. I guess you would know either way, right? But so there's a cartridge. I'm going to take the cartridge out so I don't forget to take it out, because I've done that multiple times. Because I do need that to play it. So set this aside. Due to the strength of the adhesive used, the adhesive tape may damage surfaces if you attempt to remove it after application. Wow. So I don't know if that's to stick it on the wall. If it is, then I'll probably not stick it up. But let's see. So there's the front of the box. I realize I didn't show you guys this, the front of the box. I don't believe there's any going to be anything on the back part of this, but I guess I should check. Nope. Kind of cool though. So let's see. Is that it? So there's that. I haven't seen it yet. Let's see what else is in here. Is there anything else? Nope. Just, I guess they're worried about it breaking or it damaging something, that they made sure to put a lot of protection in place. So we're gonna set that. All right, so that's a piece of cardboard. Oh, it's the same design that's on the art print. Oh, this is like a magnet. Okay, so it's kind of like, I wonder if you could use the, what do they call those? Let me know down in the comments, but there's another company that does metal posters, so you might be able to do it that way. So there's an important label here, in case you actually use it. I'm not gonna do that, at least not here. I might actually put this in another frame to keep it nice, as I do want nothing to scratch it or anything like that, since it is like a steel thing. And it's gonna go back in this container, just how it is, so. Oh, it's very thin too. I understand why they protected it. That is super nice. Yeah, I'm definitely getting a frame for this. I want this up immediately. Super nice. I like the detail. I love how it feels. The surface of it is super nice. But I know that's gonna get scratched so easily. So I'm gonna make sure it's protected before even hanging it up. But there it is. All right, so that was the entire collector's edition. We're gonna go ahead and wrap it up. We will switch camera and goes back, give my final thoughts on it. All right, so that was the collector's edition for The Legend of Zelda Tears of the Kingdom and a bunch of other goodies that I got same day. I sadly didn't get the Pro Controller yet. I'm hoping that they put that back on sale if I missed it, and so I can get that as well. Don't know if I'll make a video on that. Let me know down in the comments if you guys wanna see a video on that. But I really enjoy this. I think this is a really good collector's edition. I'll put a lot of this on display, as well as trying to get frames for all of this so that I can keep them pristine. I don't know how easy that's gonna be for different dimensions. They kind of seem out of the norm, or at least they're thicker than maybe some picture frames will have. But also, if you wanted this case, you don't need the Zelda OLED or any of the OLEDs. You can actually have it for the original Switch as well, and that actually comes with the screen protector for the original Switch as well. So just in case you're looking at getting the base Switch, this also will work with that. But it does work with the OLED, which is the important part, because not all regular Switch cases will work with the OLED. Just keep that in mind. And the amiibo, I just collect because I like collecting them. So let me know down in the comments what you guys think about this collector's edition or any of the other items I unboxed today, as well as make sure you go check out the live that we're doing today and over the next few days, guilt playing through Tears of the Kingdom. And make sure you follow the links down in the description. I'll probably link to the game and some other things down there. Some of them are affiliate links. They'll be marked that way. And that just means that we get a little portion of the sale if you do purchase anything through our links. So thank you for that if you do that. And thank you guys for watching. And I'll see you guys in the next one.